We are now talking about confidence interval, and what we are talking about is to give an estimate of the parameter of the population that is unknown using a formula that is based on the sample statistics. And in the case that we are presenting, we are talking about how to estimate mu using a confidence interval. And to estimate mu, that is an amount that is unknown, we are going to use the sample mean, and using that formula to end up with a lower bound and an upper bound. What it is important to retain in terms of the last point that we mentioned in today's lecture is related to the interval width. We agree on the following, that the interval width has to be narrow to be useful for the decision-making process. And to make it narrow, we have to look at those three terms, the n, the sigma, and the confidence level. The confidence level is, for example, the statement that the probabilistic statement that I'm making, I'm saying that I'm confident 95% that the population mean range from 300 to 400. Okay? And the confidence interval, if you are going to increase the confidence level, keeping everything in place without any changes, and for the same n, for the same sigma, from the same population, if you would like to increase the confidence level from 90 to 95, using the same data, you will end up with a wider confidence interval. But here, we have the first problem. Do we need a wider confidence interval? Well, we don't need a wide confidence interval. Then we have to balance between the two. How to balance between the two? By increasing n. For example, if I take the example of the health problem, I would like to know the percent of people who have the disease. Yes. And if you fix 95% confidence interval, you end up with a certain confidence interval. 95%. Like if you are willing to compromise a little bit in your confidence and say 95% is too much, I will be happy with 90%, then you can end up with a narrower confidence interval. Okay? The more that you would like to be confident, the wider the confidence interval will be for the same results. But I do not want to make it too wide, because too wide means that I'm not going to, it's not going to be useful in terms of the decision making. Then, if I found that it is too wide and you would like to make it narrower, you can increase the sample size. Okay, this is the story. So to say, I want to make wrapping up for that part. If the width of the confidence interval, if it is narrower, it is better for the decision maker. But to be more confident, the more confident you would like to be, you have to have a wider confidence interval. But if it is too wide for the decision maker, then you have to increase the sample size. If you find it too wide for the... in practical, usually, we are using 95% confidence interval. And sometimes we are using 90% confidence interval or 99% depending on the application. But usually we are using 95% confidence interval. Then if you end up with 95% confidence interval and the decision maker finds it wider than he expects, then he has to pay the price to make it narrower. Make it narrower by increasing the sample size. Okay? Easy or difficult? Any question? Are you confused? You are not confused? You want to be confused? Okay. Pedra. This is the same drawing that I made here. If you have 90% confidence interval, it is wider than the 95% confidence interval. And as I mentioned, we have the confidence level, and we have also the population standard deviation. And here it is showing three different levels of the sigma. The green one is the larger standard deviation, but the population is spread over wider range, and the black one is sigma equal 1, and that one is sigma equal half. Then if you have a wider population, the original population is wider, there is more spread, there is larger sigma, then you are having a wider confidence interval. How to solve that problem? To increase the sample size. This means that if you have two populations, one that has a large sigma and one has a small sigma, then in the large sigma you need to pay more price. You need to pay higher price. Higher price is the distance, needs to have a larger sample size. Then to compensate for working with a population that has a large sigma, you need to have to increase the sample size. Of course, the N, as you mentioned, increasing the sample size will decrease the width of the confidence interval, while the confidence interval can remain unchanged. While the confidence level, and for the same confidence level, if you want to make it narrower, increase the sample size. Note, this also increases the cost of obtaining additional data. Increasing sample size, sometimes it is expensive. If you are doing, mesela, a survey or a public opinion polling, and you are working with 2,000, and somebody tells you, this confidence interval is too wide, you have to have it, then you have to, instead of using 2,000, you have to use less than 3,000, which means more cost, higher. We have an important term, which is the error of estimation. Now, the sampling error. The sampling error is in itself the range that we are talking about. It's not an error from the mathematical point of view, it is a sampling error. And if you are using sample, if you are using your sample, versus using the whole population, what is the range that you are working on? This is what we call the sampling error, or the error of estimation. And it is expressed as the difference between the X bar and the mu. As we mentioned, the term that we are using and subtracting is Z. Lambda Z alpha over 2 times sigma divided by square root of n, and this is what we call the error of estimation, the amount that we are adding or subtracting from x bar to find a range for you. We are estimating only. But this is the difference that you are adding or subtracting. But this term is the error of the estimation. With, and I'm going to call it A axelem, or B. B is the first. I'm going to call this error B. If you make B equal Z times sigma over square root of n, then you can make some calculation and find out n, and n, this is the sample size that you need to use to have a certain amount. usually you are asking, what is the right sample size? How big the sample is, etc. This is a simple calculation for the sample size, but of course, if you specialize in statistics, you are going to find more details that are linked to that topic, but this is just to satisfy your eagerness to know, because many people ask me about what is the sample size, what is the value of the sample size. This is how we are getting the value of the minimum sample size. Any question? If the term B, this is the term that we are adding or subtracting from X bar to find out the lower limit and the upper limit, and we are calling this the error of estimation, and we can use this error term to evaluate the sample size that you have. If we go back, for example, to the example of the health problem, and we would like to know an estimation of the people who have a certain disease, and I will calculate the confidence interval, and I'm going to say, for example, the proportion range from 10% to 18%. That the range is from 10% to 18%. Huh? 8. Now what would be the error of estimation? Check now, if I added something and subtracted something, that is a gap.
Consultant.
The range, the level of confidence, is from 10 to 18. And 10 to 18 is a x bar minus Hagen, x bar plus Hagen. Where the amount that you are subtracting from x bar and adding to x bar is the error of estimation. What would be the error of estimation if I'm looking at what confidence intervals from 10 to 18? So 8 is the 4. Make sense? 14 minus 4 and 14 plus 4. You are from 10 to 18. The difference?
Is B.
طبعا. But it's got in the middle. مش هتصرف في something and adding something, فايه هو ال something ده اللي هو؟ يبقى the V is here. فا if I go back to the example of the health, if I tell you مثلا that I would like to know the doctor's interval for the number of people who have the disease, and I tell you it ranges from 10 to 18, then the error of the estimation is 4%, is 4 points. Okay? But if you think that 4 is too much, and you have to reduce it to 3, right, you have to increase the sample size. You agree? You agree? If I agree that if you would like to reduce the estimation, the error of estimation, you have to increase the sample size. Now increase it by how much? I can plug it here. If V is 4, this will be the end. If V is 3, this will be the end. So I can make and calculate the sample size that is required. Why I'm using this formula? Because sometimes you are asking me that how much is a good sample size? How much do I hope to go? 1,000, 1 million, 10, 15, etc. There is a formula that relates the sample size to the lower AML bound of the difference of the error of the estimation. Now if you think, for example, another application. If you are, there is a company that is producing new medication. For new medication, the bound should be very small. The bound should be very small. And you need a confidence level, high confidence level. You might decide to say that I need a larger sample size. But how large is the sample size? How far you want to go? For a bound of, not 4%, not 1%, but in the meantime, I want to be confident which 90%, 95%, or which 95%, 99%. But you can use this formula. I took examples, but I'm just presenting the idea. To illustrate, suppose that before gathering the data, the manager has decided that he needs to estimate the mean demand during heat time, the example that we talk about today, with 16 units. But instead of using, and at the beginning he thought that the sample size of 16 is enough. Okay? The sample size of 16 is enough. But what we have for this 95%, and the sigma, as you remember, is 75. He calculated the sample size and he found that the sample size is 84. The sample size is
84.
Well, you have to sample size because you have different points at the impact. Because the calculation is very good and you can round it. If it is less than 5, you can take it out. If it's 5 or more, you can make it 55. Okay? But for a given calculation, you need 84, right? Okay. I mean, example number, okay. You remember, and we started our example by saying that he has a sample size of 25, and he ended up with a range that was ranging from 344 to 399. That is the confidence interval. But an error referendum, error of estimation, can مثلا can in 44 the that can مثلا نقول 56, yeah, error at 28. Now he thinks that 28 is too much. He wants to have the error at 16, or 20, 16 units. If you want to have the error at 16, you need a sample size of how much? 84. Okay, I have a sample size again, 25. If you need to be more precise, if you need a narrower sentence, narrower confidence interval, what you have to do is to go from 25 to 84. This is the idea of the sample size.
أنا؟ لا فاهم الحمد لله.
ولا في حاجة فاهمها؟
الحمد لله.
مش فاهمة إيه؟ الحمد لله
مش عارفة. مش عارفة. لا لا مفيش.
طيب خليني أقول الستوري كده بطريقة إجمالية. إحنا يوجوالي بنستارت باي سينج ذات أنا جونت يوز ستاتن سايز أوف 25 مثلا. مش ضروري 25 كل مرة يعني ليت أس أسيوم ذات وي ستارت سامي سالا 25 من ديس اكزامبل. And we end up with the confidence interval. As a decision maker, you prefer to see the sample size that is a wider, that is a narrower. If you think that the sample size was wide, too much for you, but I'm going to say that this sample size that we calculated in the previous example, an error of estimation can occur. The error of estimation myself was 30. Like 30 is too much. I wanted only 60. But the decision maker was not happy with the confidence interval. He think that's too wide. Like, what should he do? He should increase the sample size. But increase it, we can again. It depends on how accurate you would like to be, how precise you would like to be. If instead of using a wider confidence interval, you need a narrower one. Now how narrow you would like to be? I want to have the Vahela in the question. You need to have the error of estimation 16 points. Then it will be x bar plus 16 and minus 16. To have it 16, then b has to be 16. And the other two values are the same. No change. The same confidence level and the same sigma. To have a confidence interval with an error estimation of 16, you need a sample size of 84. Instead of can sample size can count 25. Previously it was 25. Okay, but this is a story. You can create the confidence interval. You show it to the decision maker. He said, you know, this is too wide. But how narrow you would like to go? I want to go to only 16 points, plus or minus 16. But if you want to go to 16, if this is the sample size I should use, but you have to increase your sample size instead of using the sample size of 25, you have to go to the sample size of 80. Together, okay, Maya? Okay. 84, sir? Let's say, any questions?